Well, look, we thought this was something that Spain would accept a few weeks ago, and then they backtracked, and then we thought there would be no agreement, because the fundamental red line, as has been made clear and as is to be expected, is that we will not accept that there should be a Spanish presence in the airport to control entry into Gibraltar on the basis that once in Gibraltar, people are free to move without any further control in 27 European states. Well, 20, I think it is 25 European Union states and two non-European Union states that make up the Schengen area. So we understand the problems. That is to say that we are talking about a treaty that what we've got at the moment is an understanding of what the treaty will reflect, which is acceptable to us and unacceptable to Spain, although it will not be an agreement with Spain. It will be an agreement between the United Kingdom and the European Union. But the European Union has actually said almost from the day after the referendum, that they would not agree anything on Gibraltar that Spain would not agree to. So in effect, there would be no point in trying to do an agreement with Schengen, which was going to be vetoed by Spain. That would be useless. So we need to know that Spain is not going to veto anything.
And the cabinet has also had an opportunity to veto the agreement as it's progressed?
We have been involved after every meeting where something else has been added or taken away, and then Fabian and Joseph have come back, reported, and we've discussed it, and we've decided whether he could continue or we should pull the plug. This is how the negotiations have been done. You know, so in effect, we were ready to pull the plug a couple of weeks ago, and then there's been further developments, which has not been developments in a direction different from the one we were earlier on, really. But this is something that we have to do if we want the frontier not to be a hard frontier, right? In the sense that requires that we have got to show our passports to go into the European Union, into Spain, and our position is that whatever we have to do to go in that direction, we will require people to do to come into our direction. So we ourselves would then, by virtue of our policy, create an obstacle for the 14,000 workers coming in, because we would not allow them to come in and just by waving an ID card from a distance if we had to have our passport stamped every time. So
that wasn't really a viable alternative. But what would you say?
It wasn't
to somebody...
not a viable alternative. But look, everything in life is viable or not viable depending on how much you value certain things, and therefore any Spanish presence in Gibraltar is worth, as far as I'm concerned, having a closed border. It's as simple as that.
So basically, you've always been a defender of British sovereignty. What would you say to somebody who's concerned that today's agreement could be a sellout?
Well, first of all, there is no agreement. What has been done at the moment is identify what would go in the agreement. So this is not binding. It may not happen, and therefore it cannot be a sellout of anything, because Spain can change its position between now and the signing of the agreement, and so can we, and so can anybody, and so can UK, in theory. So when the final agreement is written in a legally binding legal text, which will be signed by the European Union and by the United Kingdom, and where therefore we have got a legal obligation, then if there's anything there that gives up any of our sovereignty, that would be a breach of our sovereignty. No agreement that does that would be signed by the United Kingdom, and if they wanted to sign it, we would not approve that it being signed.
So for anyone who's concerned about approach to an agreement with Spain or getting closer to an agreement with Spain, which is what this agreement in principle does, you would say that don't be concerned, so far, so good?
Well, I would say more than that. I mean, because so far all that we're talking about is what may be possible. We think it's possible. What we've done is that, given that the position was close enough for us to think it could happen, that has enabled Spain to allow to the European Union, to the European Commission, and ask for permission not to enforce the rules of Schengen and the EU on us as a non-member territory. So we are going to be continuing as if we had not left the European Union at midnight tonight for the period of negotiation of the new treaty.
Okay.
If there is, at the end, a text that in any way puts British sovereignty at risk, and what is more important, because British sovereignty is there because we want to be part of the British family. At the end, it is the wish of our people and the right to self-determination of our people that is being defended.
Sure.
If people wanted to be something other than British, there are plenty of countries to choose from rather than Spain.
I understand.
That would still apply.
It's
a question of the people have clearly made the position in referenda. It's something that I have fought for since I was 25 years old in 1964, when the first United Nations decision of the Committee of 24 pointed us in the direction of Spain. That's when I decided to dedicate my life to pointing in the opposite direction.
Two last questions, if I can, Sir Joe. Firstly, in short, will Gibraltarians, should the agreement manage to mature in a way that that you are satisfied with, would, and obviously the Chief Minister, Fabian Picardo, and the rest of Cabinet, would Gibraltarians fly into Gibraltar without having to go through any Spanish checks, and also be able to fly out to London without going through any Spanish checks?
Not just Gibraltarian, any Gibraltar resident. Any Gibraltar resident, anybody who is living in Gibraltar, if we have an agreement with Schengen, will be able to come into Gibraltar because he's being treated as a Schengen resident. And once in Gibraltar, he would then be able to travel, if he wanted, to Helsinki by car without having to show anybody any document.
Sounds all right, actually.
That's a good bit, you see.
Economically, finally, Sir Joe, as Minister for Economic Development, any implications that arise from what has been agreed in principle, and certainly, I think, customs union has been mentioned. Would you support that going forward?
No, I am not keen on the customs union. The customs union is something we didn't want to go into in 1972, when we were negotiating entry in 1973. The structure of our economy is not a structure where we export things, and therefore, if we are tied into a customs union, all it does is it limits who we can buy from, because in exchange for that, we get preferential treatment for what we make, but we don't make anything. So I don't see any advantage. It has been argued that if there is no customs union, they can stop cars to see if people are smuggling anything into Spain. Well, look, I don't think, but it's not a decision for now. It's something we are prepared to look at, but I am certainly, at this stage, I'm not persuaded that that is in our interest, and I'm looking at it from the perspective of what is good for the economy.
Sure.
The economy doesn't just depend on the number of people across the border. In any event, the post-Brexit economic plan, which is there, if there is no agreement, is equally important and valid if there is an agreement, because it is about ensuring a more self-sufficient Gibraltar, and a more self-sufficient and prosperous Gibraltar is what will always protect it against anybody at any time, and that's where we need to be.
Okay, Sir Joe Bossano, many thanks for your time. I wish you all the best for 2021.
Thank you, my friend. Same to you.